Hey YouTube, welcome back to my channel. This is Canadian Retro. I've got another pickups video for you here. This particular pickup was actually a Kijiji deal, but I didn't want to add it into other pickups just because there's a ton of stuff here that goes along with it, so I thought I'd get started. Now, when I originally saw this Kijiji deal, there were no images or anything like that, and I should have took that as a warning because the condition of these items are pretty buggered, basically. So I'm not really overly impressed with this particular pickup, but you can be the judge of that. You tell me what you think of what I got here. But again, like I said, I'm not really happy with it. So originally, the person had posted, said they had a Genesis system with 12 games, and I messaged them back saying, hey, what games are there? And they listed off like Mortal Kombat, Mortal Kombat 2, I think she said. She said there was Rolo to the Rescue. There's a bunch of different ones in there, and she also said that there was Castlevania, which obviously means that there was Castlevania Bloodlines in it. And when I saw that, I was like, hey, I want to get this lot. Didn't really care about the other games so much, even though some of them I don't have in my collection already. I still was like, nah, I'm not really that interested in those other titles, but, you know, I really wanted that Castlevania game. So I knew it came with a system, but she didn't have the cords for it. She did list that part of it. She listed off, you know, the Mortal Kombat games, the Rolo game, Castlevania, and she said that there's more games in there as well. And I was like, that's cool, like, I'll give you $50 for the whole thing, considering the fact that I'd be getting a system, and that Castlevania game's a $30 game, and the rest of it would just be kind of like, you know, butter on the top kind of thing. That's what I was thinking with it. But when I actually got there, she pulled out this box, and I looked through, and I'm like, hey, there's no Castlevania game in here. And she goes, oh really, it should be in there kind of thing. And I don't think she was trying to pull a scam or anything like that. I think she honestly legitimately thought that it was in there, because she just was telling me what was in there from memory, because it was kind of shoved into like this kind of box sort of thing. And she was just telling me what was in there from memory. So I took a look at the stuff, it was kind of beat up, and I said, hey, you know what, like, I'm not going to give you $50 for this. I was really looking for the Castlevania game. That's the one that I kind of wanted to get my hands on. And the rest of the stuff I'm really not that interested in, but I tell you what, since you took the time, and I took the time to come up here, because it took me about, you know, 25 minutes to get there, which means it takes me 25 minutes to get back, so you're looking at, you know, essentially an hour out of my day kind of thing, just for one deal. Because of that, I'll pay you $30 for this stuff and take it off your hands, but, you know, if you can find that game, let me know, and we'll figure something out from there. So this is what I got for my $30. Let me know what you think, because I'm not really overly impressed, but I had to walk away with something. I couldn't, go there and end up coming home with nothing and wasting all that time. So this is what I picked up. It came with a Model 2 Genesis. You probably can't tell, but it's extremely dirty. It's filthy, it's scratched up, it's pretty beat up, and I have no way of testing it because this is all that it came with as far as cables and things like that. It just came console only. So this may or may not even work. The next thing was a power pad controller. This one here is kind of interesting in that the joystick here has this like slot. So my guess is you would screw in different types of joysticks and handles and stuff like that to use this pad differently. It's got the 6 buttons, so I'm assuming, you know, it's like the 6 button setup, which is kind of nice, but again, it's in pretty bad shape, and on this end here, it's starting to come apart, so who knows if this even works. The next thing is a pretty neat little controller, but again, it has issues, like it's exposed wires right there, and it's this one, it's called 3 button replacement pad. That sounds pretty interesting. But it has like turbo and slowdown and stuff like that on it. So it's kind of neat. I don't know if it's that good. We'll have to see. We'll have to see if it even works. I'll have to end up taping that up or something like that. But you know, not really too impressed with that. And then finally, there's a first party original Genesis controller that came with this lot. The first game is the bane of my existence as far as Genesis collecting. I have a hard time generally finding Genesis titles in the wild. When I'm at thrift shops, I can't find them that much. I go to pawn shops that don't even have Genesis titles at all in them, and they don't really get them in. things like that. So when I'm, you know, trying to find Genesis stuff, it seems to be eluding me basically. And this particular game is basically like water. It just keeps it reappearing no matter what I do. It's unbelievable. And it's Tommy Lasorda Baseball. And this I will burn because I cannot stand getting this game anymore. It's driving me nuts. No matter what I do, this game always seems to pop up. I get a lot of Genesis stuff. This always comes with it. So this is my third copy of this in my very, very small Genesis collection that I have so far. So I'm looking to get rid of this. If you want this pile, this is more than, you know, you're more than happy to take this off my hands. You know, trade me something for it if you feel like it. The next ones, it kind of gets a little bit better, but not by much. A lot of sports titles were in here. The first one I'll show you is NBA Showdown 94. Again, not a huge deal. I'm not really interested necessarily in these titles. Football 94, Joe Montana. Again, I'll never play this. NHL 94, I might play this, but I already have this. Actually, I think I have this one complete in box, so I'll just go check that right now and I'll let you know. Yeah, so I already have NHL 94 complete in box. So, you know, not super stoked about it because I already have it. And then the game I also have is this one here, NHL Hockey, and the top of this one's really beat up. So the condition of these are less than favorable. I don't know if it's showing in the actual image here, but not minus the sticker stuff, I can get that off, but they're actually pretty beat up labels and things like that. The next ones are actually a little more interesting, so I'll get started on those right now. The first one is a rather beat up copy of Ms. Pac-Man. So, you know, that's pretty cool. I didn't have this one already, so that's kind of neat. Another one is David Robinson's Basketball, Supreme Court, I think it's called, yeah, Supreme Court. And that one's totally worn, like you can barely even see the label there. The next one is Mortal Kombat 2, which I actually bought yesterday for $3. But this one is actually a label upgrade because the other one had a tear in the label right here, so this is kind of cool to pick up. I can replace that. This one's actually in better condition. Not saying that this one is in great condition because it's pretty beat, but still. And then Mortal Kombat 3. Also picked up a little bit more wear than I'd say Mortal Kombat 2, especially right here. Now the next few games somewhat interest me a little bit more because those titles are fairly common. These ones are, I think, less common, not necessarily uncommon or anything like that, but I just haven't seen them before in the wild lately. So the first one I'll show you here is Syndicate. I remember playing this on the PC. I loved this game on the PC. I'm pretty sure the Genesis version is probably a massively watered down version of it, but still I want to check it out and see what it's like, because I never actually played this on the Genesis because I always played it on the PC. The next one is Shadow of the Beast 2, and this apparently is an impossibly difficult game, which is perfectly fine, I don't mind. Luckily this one's in fairly decent shape, so you know, it's one of the better condition cartridges. And then finally in there is Rolo to the Rescue, and this is probably the most valuable game in there, which doesn't say much for this lot, but there it is right there. It's in pretty decent shape too, it just needs some cleaning. Like there's like different kind of, I don't know what it is, like marker or crayon or something on there, and same with the label, but I'll go over that, clean it up. Hopefully it'll look fairly decent when I'm done with it. Probably the gem of the whole thing, the most valuable item, had nothing to do with this particular pickup, and it's a PlayStation 2 memory card that for some reason was just chucked in there. So there it is right there. That's probably the most valuable thing in the whole lot. So basically that's everything that I picked up. It was my $30 deal. Again, like I said, I'm not super happy with it. I guess it's not too bad. I was just expecting a little bit more, so it kind of let me down when I got there and I took a look at these things. But you know, you win some, you lose some, and I probably should have known better. I should have asked for pictures and stuff like that, maybe a more detailed list of what was in the box, and her to make sure that it was. She just didn't really have it organized or anything like that, and I think that's really where it kind of fell apart. But ultimately, you know, for $30, it's not too bad of a deal, I don't think. You know, that's everything for this particular pickup. I should have another Genesis pickup, actually, and this one I have images of, so I know the condition of the things that I'm buying this time. but that should be coming up around New Year's Eve, I think, like, is the day that that deal is going down. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. Feel free to thumbs up this video if you feel so inclined. And thank you very much for watching, and I will see you all later.